This is my cool paint booth. You can tell it's very cool. So I did the other panels. I've got this panel and that panel to do. But so you saw all the different ways we decided to do it. That's what I want to get to. I'm not going to get to that. But I like how this turned out. Okay. So as you can tell, it is very, very just dark, and you could definitely tell there's highlights of it in the different parts of the light. Like over here, you can see, you know, then as you move down, it disappears and stuff. But yeah, so this is the new way we've decided to do it, and it looks very, very weathered and old. And I think actually this piece is done completely. Yeah, so this piece is done completely. That's pretty weathered. And it's, you know, you can see, like, there's, like, a line there, and there's a line there, and I'm going this way when I paint it. And so there's not a good, you know, I'm going with the grain. But it's very dingy looking, you know. And so it looks really cool, I think. And so I think that's what we're going to go with, because we actually sprayed it with another kind of paint, and we got that. That looks terrible. So we've gone from this to this. And I like it. So we've used this again, but this time with paint. The first three you saw, which was the brush, the sprayer, and the roller, that was all with stain, with that gray stain. The next two, this one, which is a crappy one, and then the other, and then the one that we're going with, is with latex paint. And I basically took this darker gray latex paint, and then I took a, you know what, it's going to take too long to undo that, but it's a darker gray latex paint with a little bit of light gray, and a little bit of brown, and a little bit of green, like forest green, and I mixed them all together, mostly dark gray, and painted it on there, and used the sprayer, and it does these panels in about 5 minutes. So, Haunt panels, almost done. I just have two to do, and I'll be good to go. I gotta cover the pool first, because the pool's got stuff in it, and I don't want to get paint in the pool. So, we're gonna cover that, and then we're gonna paint. But it's a little windy today, so we may not actually paint today. I think I might not paint today because of the wind, and I don't really want to get the spray all over the place. So, I just wanted to show everybody the final look of our panels, and then we're actually going to put 1x3s. We're gonna frame these out 1x3, and then we're gonna put a 1x3 going in the middle, so it'll have more of a frame. So it'll look kind of like that. I like the way that looked, the frame, but it'll be a full 8-foot panel, and then that will also hide the seams of the boards together. So it'll look pretty cool. So think of it kind of similar to this idea. You know, how you have the different panels, but not so, you know, obviously not so spaced out. I do have flats done, and I have more over there. Those are the ones I did earlier, that you saw earlier on the other video. By the way, I'm filming this before I've even posted the other vlogs and stuff. So today we're going to take a, we're going to drill all the holes in the sides to do the bolts, because we're going to bolt this all together. It makes it super fast to put together and super fast to take apart. Spider legs. And so we're going to measure out where they're going to go, which I've already done. I can actually show you on this one over here what I'm going to do. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do it at, because these are 6'5.5". So what I'm going to do is we're going to do it at 4'11". And we're going to do it at 1'7". The thing is, it's going to be a little tougher to do this than I thought, because the idea is that I was going to drill all of these so that the holes are in the exact same spot. Problem is, I need to drill them in the exact same spot on the wood as well. And some of these are 2x4s, and some of the, well, these ones I'll all do together. It's funny, as you start explaining something of how you're going to do it, it goes, oh wait, we can't do it that way. Okay, so I cut out this part because I had to rethink about what I was going to do. So because I've got two different panels, I've got two different sizes of the edging. I've got 2x3s and I've got 2x4s. It won't be able to pre-drill any of the 2x4 to any of the 2x3s, but all the 2x3 panels are all going on the top. They're all going to be the second story of the cabin. Those are going to be the bottom story. So those can all be cut. Those can all be drilled together, and those can all be drilled together, the ones to the top and bottom. So I can pre-drill it. I just got to make a jig, and I have an idea. So you see how I'm going to have to do this right here. So I've got to basically space out where this is going to go on every single board. Well, get this little... that's going to be weird looking on video. Oh, look, molehill. Damn it. I hate these moles. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this, I'm going to cut it to the exact height of this board, and I'm going to pre-drill that. Then every time I go, I'm going to take this little piece right here after I cut it, and then I'm just going to put it on every board with a hole already through it. So then I just drill through it, pew, 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 pew. And every time it's the same exact height. Yeah, that's going to be awesome. So today, one of the many projects we're doing today is we're going to create the door for the facade. Made out of cedar fence boards. Yeah. Free, of course. And we're going to make the Z pattern on there, or reverse Z, whatever I decide to do. But as of right now, this is what it's going to look like. And then it's going to go on the facade. We're going to cut that out today, mount the door, make that be pretty awesome on there. So, yeah. Okay, cool. That's it, I made?
No.
Yes, you do. Yeah, look. I made a door.
What are you guys working on?
Christmas.
It was Christmas?
No. Hey, look. We've got a door. Okay, that's not going to be in there. That's going to be in the witch's thing, but we have a door frame. It's a nice clean cut on there, I have to admit. So, now we're going to install the door. I gotta admit, that's pretty cool looking. See how much battery power we have. Well, 17 minutes, that's not enough. Nice. Alright. Alright, the next thing we're gonna work on is we're going to tear apart those shutters right there. And we're going to make them actual shutters because we're going to cut off that bottom section right there and keep that section there. And then I think that we're going to start on putting, probably one of the next things that we're going to do is we need to put, we're going to get scaffolding this later on this week. But we're going to put 2x4s on the back of this. They're going to go up right there, up right there, up right there, up right there. So wherever the two panels meet is where we're going to put a 2x4. And what that's going to do is it's going to hold the back of the top panel. And then we're going to also secure the panels to the walls. You know, I'm going to put some hooks and do like the aircraft cable or some wire, some metal wire and stuff like that. So I think that's what... will be the rest of the night is doing that. So I think we're gonna do the shutters first. All right. Okay. So you can tell, put that up there like that. There we go. So you can tell that there are, I should probably take those down because they don't look cool. But I just can't believe now those lines don't match up. That's a little weird.
Oh well. I'll have to figure out something with that, because I don't like that. Anyways, those two match up. Those don't. Those do. Maybe I can figure something out. I don't know. Anyways, so you've got up there, you got two windows up there, and the third pen right there. So, problem with it is, you can tell, don't ask me how this happened, but we have a gap, quite a gap. It's because I had to pull those as, I think it's because this header bar is not exactly flush. It was flush when I put it up, but I don't think it's super flush now. So you can tell I didn't do like a super awesome job on it, but it's there. So, and you can tell that I'm overlapping a little bit. This is not a full 8 foot span, so I kind of knew that going into it. So I'll have to make that last panel a little smaller. I'll have to recut it, which is fine. I actually have a panel that I can do that with that would make it super light. So I'll have to take a picture of this in the daytime because it kind of is not really cool right now, but I can tell you, this thing looks killer. I gotta paint that. I didn't know which panel I was gonna use up there, so I didn't paint it yet. So I've gotta go up and I'll use a stick with a brush and do some staining on it, because that's what I did right here, and you can barely tell the difference between the two. So yeah, we'll figure out on that one to get the lines to match up. It won't be a huge deal because I'm gonna put a roof up there too. The roof's gonna be the interesting part, because the roof from there is gonna be about a foot out, and from here it's gonna be about 2 feet out. So this will be like a porch roof. That'll be an eave, it'll look like. So to get up there, I've gotta use a scaffolding or a ladder and then put some blocks on the bottom of it, and then somehow get a board up there. It'll be kind of interesting. Anyways, we'll see. So, here's what we have so far. So evidently my camera decided to not record anything today. So I've lost almost everything I've recorded. So this is where we're at right now. I'm testing this out too, so this may not end up making it. I gotta fix that. That looks terrible. Oh no, I'm not. That's gonna have a cover over, so I don't really care what that looks like. Anyways, so we're at this stage now. These are the top story, the second story. So I'm painting those right now. I had a problem earlier today where I thought that these two panels, being the top and the bottom, were different color. And they technically are. What I found was that it doesn't really matter what I do with it, because this wood is different than that wood. And so it soaks in differently. This doesn't soak in as well because it was meant for shipping crates. So it's a denser wood, but it's lighter as well. Where this is just regular plywood, so it soaked it up. And you can't even, I mean, some of this you can't even tell that there's any gray on it, where this you could definitely tell there's gray. So the problem is that I really can't do anything about it unless I want to redo all these panels and completely change them. And I don't think I can match that color again. So we're gonna go with what we've got, because we've already got some back there that are painted. I'm painting these, and we'll see what this does. So yeah, not fun. All right. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get the panels up, and then I'm gonna go to Lowe's or Home Depot and get the aircraft cable to anchor it to the house. Just because like this section here is gonna have panels all the way along this, And the only thing really, I'm going to put another one of these, another up right here. But all these are going to have panels where this is going to be empty right here. Because I want, this is the entrance to the witch's room. So we're going to have, I'm going to do some better bracing over here. That was just to hold that wall up. So there'll be a wall going up there and all the way across to meet that one over there. And what it's going to do is I need to make sure that this doesn't go forward since this is a driveway. So that's all going to be aircraft cable to the house. To the house. And it's also going to be braced. This is already braced here. I'll put another one over there. Better than that, it'll go inside the panel. I'm trying to do the minimal amount of bracing to the house. I don't want to put a bunch of crap, you know, holes in the house. So, but what I will show you is look what we did. We decided to work smarter, not harder, and get a scaffolding. This was $37 to rent for a week. And it goes up 6 feet high, which is right to there. So so that means I can easily reach. I can reach all the way up to that bolt right there. So, which is the highest I really need to go. So these two panels, this panel right here, I actually put upside down. So I just got done flipping it over and reattaching it all. See, work smarter, use clamps. Clamp. And I've got tie plates up here. I got these cool boards that go up from that one to that one and they attach like that, see? Thinking structure here, people. Structure, structure, structure. And then there's one over here. Oh, that one doesn't show. There's one right there. And then there's one for that panel over there. Because those will have corners like those right there. Yeah, those will be on the corners to hold them in and all that kind of stuff. So, yes, we decided to go scaffolding because it made total sense. So, which, I mean, I was trying to do this all with an A-frame ladder and that just doesn't work. So, there you go. We have two panels already. So we'll do these two next. And then we'll go up. Though that one was hanging straight up like that. And so I was holding it from going this way while I was screwing it all in. But now I can take those down and it'll freestand. So the reason that I did, I'll show you really why, I didn't really care how I cut this because of the fact that what I'm gonna do is the windows themselves have a really large frame around each window. So what I'm gonna do is instead of trying to fit them in there and get them cut right when I don't even have them yet, I have the measurements from the lady who I'm buying them from, I'm gonna cut them, I cut them about 1.5 inches inside. So when I go to get the windows, I'm going to screw straight through the frames into here. And I'll probably put, I'll probably take some bits of 2x4s or something like that, or, you know, and put behind each screw so that it has something to really smash to. Because I'm assuming these windows are going to be a little heavy. So these are the smaller windows, so they're going to go on top. They're going to be on the top part in the middle. And so that will be the top part of that. It got dark fast, but it's only like 7:30. So we're still going to, I'm going to try to get all of it up by tonight. I'm going to leave one piece because I need to cut it at an angle. I think, yeah, I will. So, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more panels to go, and I think I can get them all up tonight. So, let's get back to it. We've got 3 up so far.
So, as you can tell, I am inside the facade, backside of it. This is a cool witch's cabinet that we've got from Becky Newman, Witch Creek Cemetery. Anyways, so
this is what we were at. The last, these are the two panels over here that I haven't put up yet. And this is what we're at now. We now have two panels up there. So the problem is I don't have, let me see if I can find my cell phone. Here's where we're at now. We're trying the roof piece up there, seeing what that looks like. Problem with it is that if you go back farther, you can see the top because I can't reach all the way to the top, and it probably would be more problematic if we left it up that high. So it's just gonna go along that top rail right there. So we'll do that across the top. The window holes are cut, everything's framed up. So right now what we're doing is we're painting the top, the roof pieces. And so we've got all this, I gotta stain that still, and cut windows. So hopefully the rest of today will be windows and trim and the roof pieces. So the trim that I'm talking about is that I wanna put a cap on both of these. I'll put a cap on that one on the side, and then the cap over there, and then probably frame this out, maybe, if I have enough wood. If I don't have enough wood, we have some other ideas. I'll probably frame up the top rail just a little bit. So I've got this really cool molding right here. I got this from the Restore, and it's 12 feet long. So we're gonna do this around the door first, and then anything extra we can use on that if we wanted to. We double it up or something, I don't know. So this area right here is gonna have burlap over it. I'll probably stain that. And then there'll be burlap over there, and then there'll be a solid wall from there to there. So you won't see any of that. And yeah, so we got the facade up, which is fantastic. And yeah. I did it all by myself. I doubt we'll be able to see it, but we'll try. I know, now we're out here in the dark. We'll try to see. I'll let that focus for me, thank you. So what I did tonight was I added more lights to each window. So what I did was I added a top and a bottom light. I think it looks really cool, especially from far away. It doesn't look so directional like it does there. But that one looks really cool like that. And then I left this one with only two in it. I think I'm going to put a third one in. I know there's gnomes there now. They're not part of the display, but they're kind of cool. So I think I'm going to leave this window here with it because it actually does flicker a little tiny bit. The new power blinds that I've ran must be doing something to them, that they're actually flickering a little tiny bit. That one's not. That one was over there a little bit ago, but now it's not. These were originally two, so I don't know. But I really like that. It looks really cool, especially further away. And then I did it over here to this one. As you can tell, you can't, well, that's our bedroom window in there too. But so as you can tell, it's much brighter. And that's three LEDs on top and two on the bottom. I really like how that looks because it kind of frames the entire window around the edge, and I like that a lot. So actually the wind blew that shutter closed. It's pretty cool. So the idea is what we're gonna do, and I can't, well, I'm gonna have to. So actually what I, let me get the light here. Okay. So I bought this speaker cable. I know, this is actually speaker cable. This is super thick. But that means it can have a long run, and it's got a lot of conductivity, or whatever you want to call it. So right now it's just ran off of this right here. Pew. Obviously not what I want to do. So right now all of the lights except for these green ones in here are ran off of that circuit. Those green ones will eventually run off of this as well. So I don't know if you saw it before. Well, you probably did because you're watching this now. But as you saw, there was wires everywhere in here. They were going up here. Now if you look, there's just one wire and then the speaker wire to go to the lights. And then one wire, speaker wire to go to the lights. One wire, speaker wire to go to the lights. So what that does is A, it cleans it up, makes it real nice and easy, and I have a lot of spaces where I can connect to. And it makes it really nice and easy to connect everything. Look at that.
And that's why I love these guns. Because you put enough water in it and it soaks into the wood and makes it look so authentic. That was so badass. All right, so today, I was a little premature on the other part of this where I said that I was going to put the roof up. I remembered that I still needed to put, the corner boards, which I did. See right there? Kind of cool. Kind of frames out the building. Kind of cool. And then Ashley last night went and put all of the ivy on. And then it goes up there to the edge. Really cool. And then we got this one over here as well, and then we're gonna buy some more so it goes down the side. So it's kind of weird how it does that. There you go, weird. So you know, it's just for the look. It looks better at night than it does during the day because it looks super green during the day, and this building's been here for a long time, but ivy would be green anyway. So we're gonna add some more. We're gonna buy another package or get some from Dollar Tree. So today we're gonna do the roof on this roof.
Collecting broken
Okay, so we have finished the porch. Almost. Details left. So I'm going to show it to you because I don't get to show a lot of things during the daytime because I don't think about it until nighttime. So here it is during the daytime.
Wow. Look at that thing. That looks so cool. And it like totally defines the space now. So what I'm going to do is that piece is going to come out here and those pieces are going to go in and that piece will come out. So because I have another one right here. So I'll make that longer. I'm going to paint it all brown and we'll be good. Yeah, so the sticks really add a lot to it. And I'll show you a little trip. See, you can't even tell right now that those are actually four pieces of plywood because the original pieces I cut were 20 inches wide. It was not, that was not wide enough. It looked silly. So, I'll show you a little sneak peek under the veil here. Look at that, see? Boom. Two pieces screwed together.
You can't even tell. Barely can tell. See, look at that. You can tell up close,
but not far away, and nobody's going to be walking over here. The closest people will be to seeing this is down there in the thing, so. Got to put this one up right now. I'm going to center it, and then I've decided that I'm not going to put one over this as of right now. If I find some other wood, then I might, but I think this would look just fine without it, and then I'll put one over that, so, because I have some more sticks still. So, all right. Let's time-lapse this part. So we've got, you know, kind of a little closer up view of the windows there. We got some cool, and then we got some curtains up there on that one, and some curtains on this one, some broken glass. So right now, actually what I'm doing is it's kind of ahead of everything else that I'm, I should probably screw that up. Anyway, so what I'm doing is I'm actually going to take our old walls from the, if you remember last year we did the West Coast Haunters Convention thing, and we use these as our walls. So what I'm actually going to do is I'm actually putting these inside the walls, inside this back room. So I'm making a little tiny room back here, and I've actually got a little Easter egg in there. Ooh, Northwest Haunters Association. Anyways, so it's going to go into both these windows. There's another panel back there. You can see I got a little rig up there to attach it all to it. So I did that. That's what I'm working on right now. And then I did the wiring for all of my
little LEDs.
They're flickering a little tiny bit. You can't really tell very well. Curtains up there in that. So those look really cool. And then I finished this window, and so what I actually did on this one is I kind of did the same thing as I did over there, is I just for looks, I'm actually gonna pop that up a little more, but just for looks back here, what I did was, you can barely tell, but it's the wood paneling inside, so that when the light's up and stuff like that, all you're gonna see is the wood paneling back there and stuff. So it's crude, it works, it's fine. So that's what we're gonna leave that like that. And that actually looks really terrible now that I can see it from this side. So I'm gonna have to do some work on that. But yeah, so we've got those up there. They'll look much better in the darkness because you won't see the top parts. And oh, and I did the trim on this, so that looks really cool. I got one more trim piece to do, but that looks, I like what that looks like. Kind of see the idea of what we're doing. See, it's kind of cool. So we'll just make this wall this in right here. It'll be awesome. So it'll also remove the idea of that we were going to have to do something with this window to cover it, so that we wouldn't have any of this light from our living room going out to the windows here. Well, if I walled it in, I don't have to worry about that. So now we can keep our windows open and keep our, not that we can see out anymore now. That was kind of the idea with these windows, was that we'd be able to see out, see that way from our window, but with the curtains and everything, you can't even tell, and how dirty the windows are, you can't even see out anyway. So I just said forget it. So that's where we're at. Uh-oh.